Church, lift up your voices and sing this morning. Hallelujah.
You love God.
church, join us and sing hallelujah.
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 For the Lord God Almighty. Dedicate this next song. I want you to lift your voices and sing this song with all your heart and just worship the Lord. Worship the Lord this morning, Jesus. Jesus, we worship you, Lord Jesus. Vagadupu halotoma ekiateau mohalau malietu umau vagadupu halotoma ekiateau mohalau church, help me sing it this morning. Fakadupu halotoma eki ateau mohalama lietu mau fakadupu halotoma eki te au mohala mali tu mau. One more time, fakatupu fakatupu halotoma eki te au mohala mali. Fakatupu halotoma eki ateau mohala mali etu mau. Oh
Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. We stand on the promise of God. Where two or three gather together in His name, He is in their midst. So we thank you, Lord, for your blessings. Thank you for your anointing. And thank you for all the blessings you have bestowed upon us. We come humbly. Humble ourselves before you, Lord Jesus. We pray that you have your way, Lord God. Hallelujah. We open our heart to you. Speak to us through your word. Uplift us. And we pray all these things in the name of Jesus, our Lord and our Savior. Amen. Amen. So thank you all for coming today. It's hard for me because I don't get used to do these things. Never preach in English. Always in Tongan. But I'm willing, because I know with God's help, I can do it. Before we go on, I would just like to share something. Today, I know some of you who have been here a few times, I shared a testimony on the first Sunday of the beginning of the year, what the Lord has put in my heart. And I'm sorry if you get sick of me saying it, but I keep saying it because it reminded me, not only me, but I believe it will challenge you also. Because to me, if it's the word from God And God is faithful. Hallelujah. God is faithful and he will accomplish that word. And I said 2023 is a year of miracles, wonders, supernatural, divine favor, all those things, you know. And I say this on Sunday, and Monday, something happened to the church. And most of the church left. So I go home and I keep thinking about the word that the Lord gave me. And I said to the Lord, how can this word you gave me accomplish? Look, all the people have left. And the Lord said to me, it's not about the people, it's about me. Hallelujah. And I'm going to share a testimony because I believe it's important. And I believe it relates to the word that the Lord gave me on that Sunday. Even though I didn't know how it's going to be accomplished and how it's going to be done, but I know the Lord already knows everything. So, you know how most of the church left. There's no more people here to play the instrument. And I guess my husband have a heart. I guess it's the calling of God or the vision that God placed in his heart. And he is a loving man. He just opened his heart to anyone or anybody. Sometimes I said to him, stop doing that. But then, you know, but that's who he is. So I said to myself, I better stop. You know, I don't want to stop him from doing, if God put it in his heart, let him do whatever God wants him to do. And he sowed a lot of seeds, you know. And I guess he have a lot of friends. I guess the Fijian. He have a lot of Fijian friends. And I think the Tongan doesn't like it sometime. Because you see, he's too close to the Fijian. But he is like that to the Fijian or Tongan or whatever. People, they come his way. He's just a loving person and he's just open his heart to anyone or anybody. So, I know, so I pay my respect to all of you Dala Dala here today. We are so honored that you are here. Willing to help, to help us. But I believe this is what the Lord was saying to me. And I think through one of the Dala Dala, that he get connected with the light, with the light. And he shared, and he met with my husband, and he shared his heart to him. And he was saying, oh, I never heard anyone share his vision like you do. And then he said that he's willing to come and support. And I was saying to myself, wow, look what the Lord is doing. He gave me a word, it's a year of miracle, wonders, supernatural, divine favor. And look, he just bring people. I think I'll just say a little bit in Tongan so Tongan can understand what I'm trying to say. Hange ko ia ko pulau he loaki aha pe ko sanuali na e o mai he e ki ele ko ia ke te au ko ta ueni o e whakaofo wa fe wa tol ko ta o e whakaofo ko e mana ko e ko e tau a ela I he ta e whakanatu la ko e ko e whakaofeina ai o tua e whai ka ki tau tol I he tau ko e ni pe a mea ko e na e hoko ma vai ua ko ni se si bia ege eki e nga fe fe hono faka hoko mo no faka ka to ko ka kai ko al pe mai e ki ga te au o ku kai ko u hinga ko ka kai o ku hinga ko au ko au te fai e mana ko au te fai nga we faka o foko au te te omi a ka kai te hange ko me ko ni ko ko hange ko to ta ko ni ko ha u o tokoni Vai vai be tanga ta e ki hono loto ki ai ba mo ne viso ne. Ala se loto ta mai o ki ko ni, ta mai leva ta mai ko e ni. O ko loto ke o alu atu o to ko ni. O po po. Ta ko to ko ta ko e ni o alu ako e ta fa ki ko ni o musika. Se ti o me alea, me ako doa. Ane ha ko ya ben ta la mai o ne Faka amu ke faka lele pia moha ki iako, ke a koi. A haipe u fie mao ke iako I he me alea, ke hau o ako. Pako sio ke he faka ofo koe o otua. O behe fo ke he toko lahia behe e mate e si a si. Kana kulea ke he wike ko o si o behe, o ku behe e si su teulanga e au a si a si. Ko au o kou langa e sia si, o kou kai kou mou tolu. Ka pala nako tau tolu e langa, o kou tui o kou e mahalo o kou tonu ke mate. Ka kou inga ko si su ko ene lea. Ko au te langa e sia si, mou hao ke tau langa, pia mou au. Paka feta ai ki he eiki. So I am so blessed to see what the Lord is doing. And not only that, but what he is going to do. It's going to be a long year, but I put my trust and my faith in God. Hallelujah. Because it depends on us, on making ourselves available to God. Sometimes we come with our talents, sometimes we come, all those things is okay, it's good. There's nothing wrong with that. But if we don't avail ourselves to God, He will lead us and direct us. Things that we never seen before, things that we never done before. We will see it, it will happen. But I want to encourage us, church, we are living in the last days. We are living in a dangerous time, evil time, even the Bible mentions it. You know? Oku whakatūta maki e ngahi aho, oku kovi au pito. Pea koe afi ange koe whoki mai ai eiki, koe toi mālo yangi ia ngau e koe afili he ngai ahon. Ke veu veu ki, ke whakamāvahe vahe, ke whaka mōwete vete, ke whaka auha. O ka pau e kai ke tau ilo e tau tolu, e mea koe tō tonu ke tau whai I he aho ni. So last week I was sharing two ministries that is occurring before the throne of God. I know it's the beginning of the year, the first month. We cast vision and we do our planning for the rest of the year. You know, but for me, it's important. The kind of spirit that we are doing the work of the Lord is so important. O kumba hau inga ke tau ilo, fai nga lau mari e koe ufai a ke tau ngā we. He ko uhinga, I believe most Christians will say, yeah, the Holy Spirit in us, that's the spirit. But the fruit is not like that. It's very, very wrong. Because we know everything by the fruit. So I want to remind us, church, hallelujah. It's going to be a long time. It's going to be a long year, but we must examine ourselves. Hallelujah. Ko fela Maria fai ake ta nga we I ahoni. I know it might look beautiful and look good outside or to the eyes of men, but only God knows. I love Maria fai ake ta nga we. Pe ko la Maria ko ya tene hanga pe ia o to destroy us. Ko me ia o ko hinga to ai ko ka kita tolu e ahoni how important it is. Don't worry about what people say. You know, that's the first thing that comes to my mind. I keep thinking, oh, but what the people think, what the people will say, you know? And it troubled me most nights. But then the Lord says to me, cast all your care upon me, for I care. Hallelujah. Cast it all to me. Our anxiety, our worry, our trouble, everything, cast it to me. Hallelujah. And I did talk about it last week. I will share a little bit. Hallelujah. To me, it's very, very important because I keep checking myself, my heart, my spirit. What kind of, because all these things come to my mind and it sometimes it make me want to do something in the flesh. But I keep reminding myself, hey, we are not fighting against flesh and blood. Hallelujah. But against principalities, power, authority of the enemy today. Hallelujah. I'm not going to hate you or you hate me or you put you down and you put me down and talk about me and I talk about you. That is not what God wants us to do today. Hallelujah. Because the enemy is so deceiving. And this is what he do. Like what I said last week. He is the accuser of the brethren. He is so smart in doing that. Especially nowadays. He can turn a brother against a brother. And he turned the brethren against the brethren. But I want us to understand, and not only that, but to know the will of God for our lives today. Hallelujah. We are called to be in people who in the seed. And this is the last thing that comes to our mind, you know, because we are living in this flesh, and our flesh doesn't like it. We want to repay evil for evil, but this is not the calling of God for your life and for my life today. Hallelujah. O gui he o toa ki tā tōru kai ki whia mai o ki tāu sāuni. Ki tō tōne kōwi aki ai kōwi. O whia mai o ki tāu tōru ki tāu mo ui aki. Ai whinangalo o toa ko e tāu lotu a huwhikina ki he o toa. Because God knows everything. Hallelujah. Pea ko o toa pe ko ia pe ai whakamau anga tōnu. He tōnu a pe whakamau ai o toa ia. He kui kai ki ahane ang hala a ana. So I will share a little bit. Last week I was talking about the greatest victory of the devil or Satan over the church. Standing the brethren against each other. Accusation has been his most effective and deadly tool in destroying the light, the power, and the witness of the body of Christ. That is what he's doing in these last days. And then we, the church, Or the brethren today, we just look at each other and we just trying to fight against each other. But we are called to shine the light. Hallelujah. We are called to walk in the power of our God. And we are called to be the witness. We are called to be the witness. Hallelujah. But our ability to accomplish our purpose in this world will be determined by the degree which we can dispel our deadly enemy and learn to live for one another. Because the devil knows. The devil knows. Hallelujah. The power that the church has today is when they are united. Remember, the devil doesn't know unity because his purpose is just to divide. That's all he do. But the sad thing is, the church doesn't understand this one. The devil, I think, understands it better than us. So the access the accuser has to most believers is through their insecurity. It drives them to become territorial or possessive. And the insecure are threatened by anything that they cannot control. And the accuser may use many seemingly noble justifications for his attack on others, such as to protect the truth or the sheep. Koe huanga ko hu mai ai koe ai tala tala ki pe ko to ta tu ku aki ki he mo ui aki dau tolu ko ka kai tui o ku hu mai ai he tai mi ko ta o ngo hange u ka ke malu e tau mo ui pe ko i kai ko ke malu e tau mo ui o ku ne hanga ia faka mana mana e ha fa hinga me ape o ko ke tau lava o pure. Pe o ku ngawe aki he toko taha tuku aki pe ko toko taha tala tala aki. Ha fa hinga fa ka u hinga o ku ngali lelei pe ia pe o ku sai pe ia. Ke na uhanga o hofi aki pe te na uhanga tala tala aki pe tuku aki aki ani ike he. Hange ko nau pe ko taha uinga o ko mau fai pe ko nga ke mau malui ai mo oni ko mau fai pe ke mau malui ai fanga CP. I've heard that too many times. Ka kapau te tau hanga faka toka ngai ko e mo vete vete pe ko e mau mau o ku faka te fito pe ia. E tai mi koe o ku tau ta foki hake ai o whenga ke tau whaka e kita pe koe malu i pe koe o kita. Koe mawai wahe pe koe mo vete vete o ku whakatupu e tau whenga koe ke tau malu i ho tau tofi a. Ka koe me ape koe ia tene hanga tu usi ki tau tolu pe a me ma fai faka lau maari e mooni. The division that is caused by trying to protect our domains is the very thing that cut us off from true spiritual authority and anointing. So the result is our losing the very thing we are trying so desperately trying to preserve, which is an incontrovertible law of the Spirit. Ko e ola, tala mai ke te tau tolu, e mole mea ko ku tau whainga koe ke tau hanga whakatolo ngā. Ai ia ko lao ia o e lao marie, pe ko e fono ia o lao marie, o ta e ala whakakikihi. Koia aguloto ke kalofaki ene moui e mole ia, ka koia e mole ene moui ko uhi ko au, tene ma uia. Hallelujah. Ko mātiu tahaono vesono wanimaia. For whoever wishes to save his life shall lose it, but whoever loses his life for my sake shall find it. Not only that, but Isaiah addressed this issue in Isaiah 58, verse 8 to 9. It tells us, then your light will break out like the dawn, and your recovery will speedily spring forth, and your righteousness will go before you. The glory of the Lord will be your real God. Then you will call, and the Lord will answer and will cry, and he will say, here I am. If only, here is the catch, if only we remove the yoke from our midst. What is the yoke? The pointing of fingers and the speaking wickedness. All this wonderful, wonderful thing. Your light will break out like the dawn, and your recovery will speedily spring forth. Your righteousness will go before you, and the glory of God will be your real God. Then you will call and he will answer you. And he will say, here I am, if only we will remove the yoke from our midst, the pointing of finger. Isn't it? This is what we do today. We just point our finger. And our speaking wickedness. Tala mai pe toki ulo atu ho mama. Hange ko pongi pongi. Pe tupu vave ho mo uilelei. Pe mo mo a iho ao. Ho ma on yoni pe mui mui ate koe. Ai nau nau o sihova. Pe teke ui pe tene taria koe. Teke kalanga pe tene pehe koa weni. O ka paupe, te tau to'o ai haamonga, ai ioke, ai whakamamawha, meho tau ao. Ko hae whakamamawha, ko ia uhinga ki aia Isaia, ko e tuhu tuhu ko e ho tau nima. Ko e tau lea whakaanga, ko e tau tuku hifo, ko e tau lea tae ikuna, ko e tau lau, ko e ngahi mea ko ni tala mai, eh, follow folaga dig that door. But you know what? Most times people complaining, we don't see that much light. And we don't see this thing happen in the church. We don't need to point our finger at people, we just look at ourselves. Look at yourself, examine yourself. What is going on? Because this is a promise of God. If we remove the yoke of criticism from our midst, which is portrayed as the pointing of the finger and speaking wickedness, our light will break out. E ulo atu e tau mama. There will be nothing that can hide the light. And our healing will come speedily, and the glory of God will follow us. And he will answer prayer. Hallelujah. And there is possibly nothing that can so radically change the church and the lives of individual believers than having our criticism change into intercession. Hallelujah. Maybe that's why there's not much light today. So little healing, So little of the glory of God, and so little answer prayer in the church today. Criticism is one of the ultimate manifestations of pride. Because whenever we criticize someone else, we assume we are superior to them. Koe anga whakaanga pe koe whakaanga, koe te whitoia o hapea asia ia mea koe ni koe pole pole. Koe taimi koe kutau piheai, o kutau whakaanga ia iha taha, o kutau pihea pe kutau tolu, o kutau lelei hake ki tau tolu, pe o kutau lelei iange ki tau tolu ia ki nau tolu. Kaukito tonu ke mau he tangata e whakakaukau koe ni. Koe whakakaukau koe ni, koe mea o kuto tonu ke tau manawahe ki ai, kohono te ke iki tau tolu he eki. That is what the word of God says. God resists the proud, but he gives a grace to the humble. I think it's better for us. We would be better off having all the demons in hell resisting us than God. Eleleiange, ki te kei ki tau tolu he whanga te volo o heli, I hano te kei ki tau tolu e otua. Kou hinga koi pole pole, kou hinga koi sihikisia. We can say, maybe we say, we can do it better than you. But we must be very, very careful, people. Proud and bright, God resists. But I'd rather be humble myself and God will give me his grace. Hallelujah. O go tui ko talanoa ko opita. Whakatata talanoa ko opita. The story of Peter on the night that he denied Jesus. Tana mai nai hanga e pita o hofi e so dia loma ko hinga ko ne whinga ke malu ia sisu hono eiki. He even challenged the Son of God, telling him that even if all the disciples, if they all fall away, but not me, Lord. Peter considered himself to be a man of courage. And he was willing to die for the Lord. The only thing he doesn't know where the courage came from. Remember, the Lord did not cause Peter to fall that night. He just removed the grace by which he was standing. Then this fearless man whose charge a Roman cohort could not even stand before a seven curl. Koe futangata tailifia, tai manamahe, koe futangata loto toa apita. Kanai kaike ilo epita koe ne tuu koe uhingape koe kelesi ai otua. All of us, we only stand because of the grace of God. If God removed his grace, oh, how sorry we are for us. Ko no to ope e kia kele siko e tau to ia e ahon. Ko e mea kong tau siu ko kia ai ke futangata ko e niko pita. Kai ke manawahe ke tangata sotea ka manawahe ke ki tahi ne kaunanga. Nane talange ki ai. Hei, koko e nake mui mui a sisu. Kaya whaka ikai i e pita. Ko hinga ko ha. Ko e tau tuu i a honi. Tau tuu pehekelesi ai iki. Hallelujah. None of us can stand at any moment except by the grace of God. Ko e fo imo oni whakatohitapia, whakafolofolaia. Ko tai me go tau fakahalaia e ni ike ko inga ko na pala pala ma o ko tau tuku pe ki tau tolu ki lalo. Pe tau to pe ki tau tolu ki hanga hala tatau. Ko lauia a paula I he tohi koe a kaledia wa he onu vese ono ulu aki. Brethren, even if a man is caught in any trespass, you who are spiritual, restore just a one in a spirit of gentleness, each one looking to yourself, lest you too be tempted. Hallelujah. Kapau e mo ua hatangata I hakovi, o ki moutolo ku whakalau maari e, whaka mo ui I he loto anga vai vai, mo ke tokanga I koe te ria, na whakatau e le I foki koe. Hallelujah. Ko tai me ko o ku tau. Whakanga I ai ha toko taha kai te ane ke he, o ku tau pehe ki he o tua ko ho ngā we, o ku I kai ke hoa pe tā uia ke he tuunga o ku mau I ai. Ko tai me ko o ku tau whakanga I ai ha whanau a ha taha, ko hai o ku tau whakamamahi I. Ko I mātu a, pe au ta tau tof pe ia pe amoe o tua. Ko e tau whakamau I hataha o ene kakai o ku tau whakamau I e ki tau tolu ai o tua. Ko e taimi ko ku tau whakamau I ai ene kautaki o ku tau whakamau I e ki tau tolu ai taki ko e ai o tua. O ku tau pehe ki he o tua o kakene ilo I a mea kune whai. Moe taki ko e o kune whakaai ki tau tolu. When we criticize another Christian, we are actually saying that God's workmanship does not meet up to our standards. That we could do it better. When we criticize someone else's children, who takes offense? The parents. This is no less true of God. When we judge one of his people, we are judging him. And when we judge one of his leaders, we are actually judging his leadership. We are saying that he does not know what he is doing with the leadership that he is providing. Such grumbling and complaining is the same problem that kept the generation of the children of Israel from possessing their promised land. Their grumbling caused them to spend their entire lives wandering in the dry places. And this is still the reason why so many Christians do not walk in the promises of God. It is so true. It is so true today. Ko e tau whakaanga I koe ha toko taha kalisteane kehe. Pe ko e tau whakaanga I koe ai toko taha taki. O ku tau whakanga I e ki tau tolu ai o tua. O tau pe e o tua koe keke ilo ko ho mea aku whai. Ai taki o ku ke o mai o ku ke keke ilo e koe ho mea aku whai. Ka ku tala mai ke te ki tau tolu. Ko e mea ta tau pe ke whanau a Isleri. Ko e mea ia nai hoko ke ki nau tolu. Ko e nau ngulu ngulu mo e nau hanu mo na la unga ko ki he odua ko ha me na he ko a me ta ka I ai pe ki na to ru I he to a fa he ta u e fa no ko wi nga na fi ma u he odua ia ke ne te si I e loto e kakai ko ni ke si o ko ha ya nga fa fo tu nga e loto e kakai ko ni and I know a lot of people saying oh how many years we don't see anything happen. But little did they know what kind of a heart that they have. Well, how I find a tukung a lot of, I'm not judging anyone or anybody. I don't. But I'm only saying it because this is what I see in the church. This is what I experience in the church. And I try not to go into those things. I try my best. Never to judge anyone, not to criticize anyone. Who am I to criticize? Hallelujah. Ko e otua pe ko ia o kune fuake e fono pe ko ia pe o to tonu. Kene fra mau ke te ko pia moa. Ko au ko tu he tu nga ko o loto hu fe ki na ma au. Kai fai he o tua ia ni nga we. Hallelujah. Fra feta. Ko tu te mata pe ai e pong pong ini. Ko tu ko share something to us so that we know how to handle ourselves when we go through things. We don't quick to judge, point finger, criticize, putting people down, gossiping up about other people. We are called to intercede for people. And that is what Jesus is doing. Well, he is the high priest, and he is interceding for us day and night. Day and night. Hallelujah. Tokanga ki ho tau loto, tokanga ki ho tau lau marie. Ko hai lau marie, fai ake tau ngā we I he ahoni. O ku mahu inga ki he otua. O fa ke tāpu ki nā ki tau tō he eki.
Hallelujah. Let's get up this morning. We're going to finish one of the song. And I pray that the Spirit of God will touch you this morning. I know the Spirit of God is here. Kuilo imo mahino ime au fai he o dua. Kua atape ke o dua I e pongpongini. Kua due mure mai o dua I kua taulo to I e pongpongini. Ang nadolu kou mamata mai he ea I e pongpongini. Te maulo tu ea ki hawat ka ding mautolu ai malohi o e lau mari e maoni oni o e o dua. Te maulo tu ea ki behe ngā ue a ene folfola I ding mautolu. Kua atape ke o dua. He kua kua ngā whakalilifu e ni uk tau mo uiai. Tonga hiva mai he kau tāmea hiva taha ye bongbong ini. Ko fua tāke toko taha ko toha be ye bongbong ini. Ko dui, ko gure ate o tua kia re koe. Ko koe be ia te ke fai e koe, ko o laka ye ahon. Ko koe be ia, ko kuke ilo I koe homo ui. Ko fua tāke o tua ye bongbong ini. Ko fua tāke re ate o tua honu lau maria kia re koe. Ko koe ia, ia la mai o tua kia re koe. Ok mooni o guhene o tua ia. Ok mooni o guhene hono lau maage. Hallelujah. Yes, Lord.
God, you're so good. Hallelujah.
just close our eyes and close our service this morning. Lord Heavenly Father, we come before you, Lord, and we thank you for all that you've done and going to do in our lives, Lord. We come here empty so that you may fill us up, Lord. Let everything we do and we say be of you and you alone, Lord Jesus. We thank you for the word that you have shared with us. We pray that we may take it and embark it into our hearts, because we know what is in our hearts. We speak, we feel, and we act, Lord Jesus. We just need you to forgive us, Lord, for any wrongdoing that we have done, Lord. We come before you and we know that you are a God who continues to pour his favor on us. Though we tend to sin and go against you, Lord, you are there and you shower your favor and your blessing over our lives, Lord Jesus. So we stand here and we commit ourselves to you and you alone, Jesus. We give you all the glory and all the honor, and all God's people say, Amen.